Welcome back. Low king salmon returns are a major concern this year in several parts of the state. Chignik, the Kenai, Copper River, Ship Creek, and Anchorage, and particularly in southeast Alaska. So much so that in its 2018 forecast, the Alaska Department of Fish and Game called southeast returns the lowest runs on record using historical information spanning many decades, noting that reduced productivity of king salmon stocks are a major concern in southeast and beyond, and that the department will manage 2018 fisheries in a conservative manner. And that's exactly what Fish and Game has been doing this summer, not only in southeast, but also in Ship Creek this year. Joining me now to help break down what's happening is Jim Hasbrouck. He's a fisheries scientist with the Alaska Department of Fish and Game. Jim, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Liz.
So let's start with southeast. What's going on there? Why are we seeing such low salmon returns?
The department believes the low Chinook salmon runs in southeast Alaska are likely caused by poor marine survival, which reduces the abundance of Chinook salmon when they return as adults.
Low marine survival, so that means that it's not overfishing.
It is not overfishing, and it's something that's going on statewide. If it was a freshwater environment phenomenon, it would likely be something that would be much more localized, whether it was something that was going on with the fish habitat in freshwater or density-dependent kind of factors that were going on in freshwater. It would be very localized. What we're observing in southeast and other places of the state is a statewide phenomenon. So we think it's poor marine survival.
And this is a trend that the department has been observing for several years now. Why is it so difficult to reverse that trend?
We originally started noticing this decline in production of Chinook salmon in 2007. I forgot the rest of your question.
You noticed the decline starting in 2007, and knowing that, why is it so difficult to reverse the trend of that decline?
Because it's marine survival, and so it's something that's going on in the marine environment. And the marine environment in the Gulf of Alaska is extremely complex. It's also probably not one individual factor that's causing the decline in marine production. You know, there could be decline in food source for the young juvenile fish when they first enter the sea. There could be competition. There could be changes in the water in the marine environment, be it dissolved oxygen or what have you.
Perhaps
there could
a predator.
Be predation. We've heard of increased killer whale and sea lion populations, marine mammals in the Gulf of Alaska, which may be causing increased predation. So it's likely not one of these things. It's probably some multiple of these factors and others that I haven't had mentioned.
So how do you go about trying to pinpoint a cause? Is that like looking for a needle in a haystack?
For this kind of situation, it would be, Liz. Yeah, because there are so many different things that it could be. How do you actually go out in a natural system and try to tease apart the contribution of each of these individual elements to the overall production of Chinook salmon?
Of course, you've got the fisheries that are putting out the same number of salmon every year, and we're just seeing the low number returning. Is there a change that can be made at the fishery level?
We have been managing fisheries conservatively. We've closed a lot of fisheries and restricted a lot of fisheries in 2018. This is not the first year that we've done that. We manage fisheries to achieve escapement goals for sustainability of the resource, both the resource itself and the fisheries that are dependent upon those resources. That's commercial, sport, and subsistence fisheries. So we are managing conservatively and doing the best that we can to achieve escapement goals to try to assure long-term sustainability of the resource and fisheries for the future.
That's right. We saw in a rare move the Department of Fish and Game closed Ship Creek here in Anchorage for a little bit because of those low king salmon returns. So seeing this trend, should Alaskans be worried about what this might mean for next year's returns or even 10 years from now, those numbers?
I would say concerned, but I don't know that I'd go so far as worried. We've seen a higher proportion of young salmon in runs that we have been assessing this year, both in southeast and south central. That makes at least me a little cautiously optimistic that the runs of the next few years may be better than they were in 2018, because we have some young fish that are coming back. Chinook salmon return over at least 3 years. They spend 2, 3, or 4 years in the ocean largely. So because we're seeing more fish that are probably two ocean fish, Hopefully we will see more returns of 3 and 4 ocean fish in the future. In addition, Chinook salmon stocks in western Alaska seem to be doing better, specifically the Nooshiegak River Chinook salmon in Bristol Bay. The Kuskokwim River Chinook salmon have achieved escapement goals the last few years, and the Yukon River Chinook salmon seem to be doing better. That doesn't mean that we are out of the woods even for those stocks, but they seem to be performing better than they were around 2007 to 2010.
All right. We'll be watching that closely. Thanks so much for joining us today to help break down this complex topic. Jim Hasbrouck is a fish scientist with the Alaska Department of Fish and Game.
Thank you, Liz. I appreciate it.